Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends. Now we are going to do a new term which is known as cell constant. So what is cell constant, which is related to electrochemical cell? So let us see what is it. The cell constant is nothing but the ratio of the distance between the electrodes, that is divided by the area of cross section of the electrode, is called as cell constant, which is denoted by the symbol B. So it is nothing but the distance between, that is the length between the two electrodes, that is denoted by L, divided by the area of cross section of the electrode, which is known as A. So the ratio of the length between the two electrodes and the area of cross section of the electrodes is nothing but the cell constant, which is known as B. And for a particular cell, the cell constant will remain the same itself, because in this case it is not dependent on the concentration, it is dependent on the length between the two electrodes as well as the area of cross section of the electrode, which will remain constant throughout the electrolytic cell. And talking about the next one, what would be the unit of B, that is what would be the unit of the cell constant, since the length has a unit of the CGS unit of the length is centimeter and that of the area is centimeter square. So the centimeter and centimeter will cancel out each other, and the thing that is left with us is centimeter inverse. And as if we have taken the SI unit, then it would be meter inverse. But usually what happens is the apparatus is so small that the distance between the two electrodes is been calculated in centimeter. So therefore we usually measure the cell constant in terms of centimeter inverse only. So this was known as a cell constant. But how can we determine for a particular cell what would be the cell constant of a particular cell? So to talk about this, we will take the help of a Wheatstone bridge, and we will decide that how can we determine a cell constant. So for the determination of cell constant, we are using the help of the Wheatstone bridge. So in this Wheatstone bridge, it consists of an electrolytic cell or a conductivity cell in which it has been connected to the apparatus such that the wire A and B has a resistance connected known as C, and this is connected in such a way that the Rx, which is connected to B, is the resistance which is known to us or which has a fixed resistance, while that of if I consider this A and this point, I would take it as M suppose. So in this case, this A and M has a connection with the conductivity cell. So when we are talking about an Wheatstone bridge, the equation will be as follows. If we could see that, but the Wheatstone bridge is only applicable if the distance or the resistance of this two equations are equal. So this is only possible if there is no current flow in the overall circuit, and this will happen with the help of this detector. This D is nothing but a detector which will detect whether the current is been flowing throughout this circuit or not. So therefore this is the jockey that is been attached on the wire A and B, that is to be that can be taken to a distance so as to measure that at what point with the wire A and B, when will be the point where there will be no deflection in the current which can be detected by the detector. So in this case, suppose a point is been obtained, like point C suppose. So in this point we could say that the distance between A and C and the distance between C and B will be such that the resistance of this solution and the resistance of this Rx will be the same. So let me give you an idea that how can we write a Wheatstone bridge in terms of its formula. So according to Wheatstone bridge, if I want to make this resistance, suppose I am taking the solution of the unknown resistance as R solution and this resistance as Rx, then the both will be equal when there is no deflection detected in the detector. So in this case, the R solution, which is directly proportional to the length, if the length increases of a particular wire, then the resistance of a particular wire also increases. So therefore, since R solution is directly proportional to the length, and in this case this R solution will have a length of AC in this case because it is related to it. So therefore, length of AC, as well as if I could see according to Wheatstone bridge, the resistance is also directly proportional to the length. So in this case, this Rx will be directly proportional to the length of CB. So therefore, this Rx is directly proportional to the length of CB. So in this case, what I could determine or what I could simplify it as, the R solution divided by the length of AC, which is equals to Rx divided by length of CB. So in this case, suppose if Rx value is already known to us and we have calculated the length of AC, where the deflection in the detector is zero, and again the length between the C and B, again that distance can also be determined, and because of help of this we could easily determine what would be the resistance of the solution of an conductivity cell. So in this case, we could easily examine that what would be the resistance of a particular conductivity cell. So this can be related to the cell constant. How? The cell constant has been related to the resistance in such a way that the cell constant B, since we know it is directly proportional to the length and inversely proportional to the area, so one more formula that has been derived, that is B is equals to K into R. Because since cell constant is directly proportional to the length, as we have did the definition of it, and the length is also directly proportional to the resistance, so suppose if the cell constant is directly proportional to the resistance, then for a constant value we have a conductivity. So therefore, in this case, B is the cell constant, K is the conductivity, and R is the resistance of the solution. So in this case, we could easily determine what would be the cell constant of a particular conductivity cell. So in this case, where K is known as the conductivity of cell, R will be the resistance of the solution. The resistance of the solution, or the resistance of the cell, and B is the cell constant. So because of help of this, we could easily determine what is cell constant of a particular electrolytic cell. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video and you have understood a clear concept what is cell constant. So thank you friends for watching this video, and share this video with your friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.